Today we're going to talk about two really important sequences, the arithmetic and the geometric sequences. Let's start with the arithmetic. In the arithmetic sequence, each consecutive term differs by a constant amount. That means if you take 2 and subtract negative 3, you get 5. Let's see, 2 minus negative 3 is, so 2 plus 3 is 5. Let's try it with the 7 and the 2. 7 minus 2 is 5. Let's try it with the 12 and the 7. 12 minus 7 is 5. And finally, 17 minus 12 is 5. Now, notice the difference between a term and the previous term is constant. This is what makes an arithmetic sequence. So this constant difference can be denoted with a D. So the difference is D. The difference between the nth term and the term before it, which we denote with A sub n minus 1. So what this means, if you took the third term, the 7, take the third term and subtract the second term. So third term minus the second term. That will give us D, the common difference. Now, geometric sequences don't have a common difference. They actually have a common ratio between a term and the previous term. So if we take the common ratio, or if we take the ratio of the 4 and the 2 here, we have 4 over 2, well, that equals 2. Let's try it with the 8 and the 4. 8 over 4, well, that also equals 2. 16 over 8, that equals 2. And the last one, 32 over 16, well, that equals 2 as well. We call this common ratio R. And we can find R by taking any term, so we'll say a sub n, and dividing it by a sub n minus 1. Now let's talk about why arithmetic sequences are so important. Well, you can do some pretty amazing things with them. First off, they have this general formula for finding any term in the sequence. So to find the nth term, we add the first term to n minus 1 times our common difference. And we also have this formula down here. What this calculates is what is the sum of the first n terms. And you can calculate it with this formula. Let's look at an example. Right here we have an arithmetic sequence, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Now, by looking at this and subtracting any two terms, for example, 12 minus 9, we see that the common difference is 3. So D equals 12 minus 9, which is 3. The common difference is 3. Using that 3, we can find the 11th term. We're going to use this formula. So our n will be 11, because we're trying to find the 11th term. So a sub 11 equals a sub 1, so the first term, 3, plus our n, which is 11, minus 1, times our common difference, 3. So 11 minus 1 is 10, times 3 is 30. 30 plus 3 is, well, 33 is our 11th term. So if we were to continue this sequence all the way to our 11th term, it would be 33. Now, what is the sum of the first 5 terms? This is actually called a series. When you add everything up in a sequence, it becomes a series. So let's see. What is the sum of the first 5 terms? Well, we could just add these 5 up and say what the sum is. But let's use our new formula. So the sum of the first 5 terms, so we're going to use 5 for n this time. So S sub 5 equals 5, our n, times the first term, which is 3, plus the fifth term, which is 15, all over 2. So 3 plus 15 is 18, divided by 2 is 9, times our 5. So this sum is 45. We can confirm this by actually adding up these terms. 3 plus 6 is 9, plus another 9, 18, plus 12 is 30, and another 15 is 45. So it works. With geometric sequences, we also have some formulas to calculate the nth term and to calculate the sum of a certain number of terms. So let's try that. Here we have a sequence, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16. We should start off by finding the common ratio. So let's take the 8 and the previous term 4. Our common ratio equals 8 over 4, or 2. So now let's find the sixth term. We can use this formula up here. A sub 6 equals the first term, which is 1, times r to the n minus 1. Well, our r is 2, and our n was 6, so n minus 1 would be 5. So 2 to the fifth power is 32, so 32. The sixth term, or the term that would go right there, is 32. Now, what is the sum of the first four terms? We have to use this formula. So the sum of the first four terms equals 1 times 1 minus our r again, 2 to the fourth power, because our n is 4 this time, all over 1 minus 2. So let's simplify that and see what we get. Negative 15 over negative 1, which is just 15. So this formula says if we add the first four terms of our geometric sequence, we get 15. So let's see what happens. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 4 is 7, 7 plus 8 is 15. So it worked.